Drop a 10.
Oh, no! Oh,
my God!
Well, I always had a desire, you know, to do something different to me. To chase swordfish is out of my realm. Something I don't do every day, and that's this kind of stuff that I love. And really, that's what this show is about, getting out of my comfort zone and doing these things. And this is definitely outside of my comfort zone. I had a friend that had fished with Eric in the past and told me how good he was at what he did. And I knew probably one of the best destinations to chase after a swordfish was down in the Keys in Islamorada. You know, what can be most difficult about these types of trips is putting it all together, getting it all to work, getting the weather to work, everybody's schedules to work. And so often, you know, it just doesn't come together. But when you can get that right weather window, everybody's schedules kind of mesh, it can be magical, you know, and that's what I was hoping for.
Little choppy, gotta take our time getting out. 30 miles we gotta go, but
slow and easy, no
slow
rush.
And steady. 20 miles an hour, we'll get there. Don't wanna beat yourself up or the boat, so just take our time.
We're using 65 pound yo-zuri super braid, and we want that thin diameter line that needs to cut through the water, so you need to use braid. It's definitely a necessity. From there, we tie a bimini twist to a wind on leader. So this is a 150 foot section of 250 pound mono. It kind of acts as a shock absorber, and then attached to that is a 10, 12 foot section of 250 pound leader that the bait is attached to. Now, all these things are crimped together with barrel swivels so you avoid any twisting.
30 mile run, we made it. So we're gonna fish two rods, a buoy rod and a tip rod. Which is the squid gonna go on, the tip rod?
We're gonna do the buoy rod on the
squid.
Squid, yes sir.
There's a bunch of different types of baits that you can use. People use squid, strip baits, dolphin bellies, eels. There's so many things that guys are using, and normally you kind of want an assortment of baits to see what they want that day.
So not a lot of competition out here today when it's blowing 15. You gotta imagine 30 mile running this. Camus did great though, ate it up.
Oh yeah.
So a buoy rod, a tip rod, we're gonna start in about 1700 feet of water, move pushing a little bit shallower, right?
Yeah, a little bit, hopefully. Just depends on where that current's actually gonna push us. With this wind, we should go a little bit shallower. It's gonna push us in a little bit, but we'll, only way to really tell is once you put that first bait down, see where it's going.
I'm excited!
So this guy's ready to rock and roll, right?
All right.
All right, you wanna go ahead, we'll bump into about 17.
Okay.
We'll start letting this buoy rod out. From there, we'll move into about 16, 1625, and we'll set out our tip rod. By that time, this buoy rod should be ready to throw the buoy on, and we're ready to roll.
All right, I'll push this a little skinnier.
In addition, we're going to fish a second bait, and that bait is, in essence, we've already measured out 1,400, 1,500 feet of line and attached a section of wind-on area that we can clip on a buoy. In essence, this is just a giant bobber. We're going to set this out away from the boat, 100, 200, 300 yards, and fish another bait at a different depth so they don't tangle. But in essence, all this thing is just a giant bobber with a flag on it. If that flag were to lay over, what that tells you is the weight has been lifted off of it and you got a bite. So either you're looking for a flag to fall over or for that buoy to just get sucked under the water.
Thank you.
Well, sword fishing has become more and more popular over the last decade. For a long time, it was a nighttime fishery. People went out at night, swordfish came to the surface. It was a lot easier to target these fish when they're up in 200-300 foot range. You know, during the day, these fish are down at 1,500, 1,800 feet of water. And you got to imagine, before the invention of electric reels on the recreational side, it was pretty difficult to do. I mean, you can hand crank from that depth, but you're dropping 10 pounds of lead. And you got to imagine reeling 10 pounds up from 1,800 feet of water is definitely challenging.
I'm still not on the bottom yet. I'm at 1,750, 1,750 revs.
So you normally drop it when you get a bite?
Yeah, I count to 10 dropping it. And I want to watch the rod tip, see if he comes back. If he hits it again and I can see it, I'm going to drop it back all the way to the bottom and then reel up. I'm going to count my way up basically, and hopefully he's hooked on at that point.
I initially reached out to Eric through social media. He is a charter captain down here. He's also a fire medic down in the Miramar area. And he has a lot of experience at chasing swordfish. And I knew he was the guy to put me on him.
It's helpful to have a comfy boat in this type of fishing. You want to have a nice seat, someplace to relax, someplace to get out of the sun. It's a lot of waiting.
Maybe the bite was earlier on.
Sword fishing definitely can be a waiting game. You can sit out there for hours for just one bite, and unfortunately, you don't always connect. You just gotta put your time in. Running in, almost ran over a tree. Can't gotta stop. You gotta stop, right?
Gotta stop and see what's
there.
There
might be some mahi on it. Fired in there.
Fire in the hole. Oh, fish on.
Fish, you found one.
Little
got
guy.
Yo-zuri.
Little guy. Kind of under you.
Oh, sorry.
Come over.
Funny
I didn't
that.
Get two pops out of that.
Boom. I almost ran the thing over.
Where's the big boy at? Is there another? There's got to be another one around.
You would think, right?
I just saw a little filefish come up. Oh, there I got him. Right at the boat.
Right at the boat on the yo-zuri. How cool is
Those
that?
Those would be some good dolphin bellies. Ooh, 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 ooh. Nice one. Really nice one right there.
Really?
Really nice one. A really nice one. This might be a legal one right here.
All right, buddy. All right. I'm gonna let you go.
I've got another pack of ballyhoo in there.
It's getting dark and we're catching mahi.
There is bait all over this thing. That was a nice fish, though.
Oh, you definitely want to be careful. This is not the time you want to hook in your hand. Look how white he is. How cool is that? Look at that. Look at the colors. It's even cooler in the dark.
Nighttime mahi fishing. For this afternoon or today, I think the first drop down, we're gonna get tight on a 300 pound sword. I'm serious.
We're gonna fight
it. We're gonna fight it for a couple of hours. We're gonna come back. We're gonna be just in time for lunch. I say we, you know, cut up a slice or something like that, go take it to one of these local restaurants and have it cooked up for us for lunch.
I'm totally down for that. I'd be so stoked.
I hope it works out that way. George, bring me to the left more.
All right.
I'm gonna go ahead and start dropping. Buoy rod engaged.
There he is.
All right, drop it. Count to 15.
Sloppy, they like to kill that bait.
Fish on?
Yeah. He's slowing that baby down. Yep, he's on. Fish on.
Yep, got him.
Fish on.
We're on! God!
Yeah, he did not want to commit,
that was
huh?
Like finesse fishing.
Oh, Lord.
1,500 feet of water.
All right, you can slow it down a little. There you go. Hopefully, that's a good boy. Good one.
Dude, how many times? That thing came up. We picked it up, dropped it a dozen times.
Yeah, at least a dozen, for sure. So these fish like to run into the current. They're running into that current and coming up at the same time. So what we're trying to do with the boat is we're trying to get in front of that fish just a little bit so we're not putting extra amounts of pressure on it. So the guy on the rod is just as important as the guy behind the wheel when you're sword fishing.
Yeah, I gotta have the harpoon ready, gaff ready, gloves ready.
You never know what's gonna happen here. This could be a small pup, but it could also be a 200, 300, 400 pounder swimming up with the weight. So you gotta be prepared for anything. So once he gets close to the surface, what we wanna try to do is get a dart shot in him as fast as we can. We're one, trying to get that weight off quick without having any slack in the line. You're obviously gonna have to stop the reel. It takes time to take that weight off. But the guy on the rod's gotta get right back on it. He's gotta basically reduce the drag just a little bit. He's gonna have to redo it. There he is.
Oh my God!
Holy shit. That is a big. All right, he's way up there. I gotta give it to him.
All right, we'll get him. 1,500 feet of water to the surface, jumped like a sailfish.
Just so happened, it is a monster.
Dude, he came all the way out of the water.
I see it right there.
I want to back off.
You want to back off. Once I grab that weight, back off. And when I get it off, I want you to catch back up. Keep it coming. Keep it coming.
Out here, guys.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Release drag.
Out here, guys.
Release drag.
Very light drag right now, very light drag. She might be up here, guys. Up here, up high.
There he is. All right, no tension. Going underneath us. Slow it down a little bit. She's underneath. She's straight.
She's underneath us. Neutral. Oh, God damn it.
How much leader's on?
Maybe fit now, 25.
All right, I'm gonna spin back around. Put her in the rod holder. I'm spinning back around forward. Just barely putting a finger on the spool. A little bit here. I want him to keep coming up, you know what I'm saying?
Going out.
Whoa,
oh, my
boy.
God.
I'm sitting on my 28 HP Camus, and this is the most versatile platform I've ever been on. And really, that's what stands out the most to me about this boat. From skinny water where I'm looking for redfish and snook, or out into thousands of feet of water where I'm looking for swordfish, this boat does it all. And it's not just fishing, it's family as well. A day at the sandbar with the kids, you know, plenty of seating to go around for the whole family, comfortable, dry, efficient ride. It runs on a Michael Peters design proprietary double step bottom in collaboration with the founder of Camus Boats, Earl Benz, who's been building boats for decades. This boat does it all. They make a full line of boats, bass boats, they make this in a 26, and now they also have center consoles in 34 and 40 foot size. And I tell you what, if you're looking for a high quality boat, I would go check out a Camus dealer near you.
Don't horse her. She'll come. We'll get her.
No. Forward.
I can't.
You had it. All right, back up and then go forward that way. She's going like right there. All right, now she's right over here.
Oh,
got her. Darn it.
I missed.
I don't know how good I got her.
Yeah, I mean, you said normally.
Normally the harpoon, yeah. I said it earlier. Normally it's the end game. I believe she was green still.
Well, she's
being
hooked. I think she's
hooked
in
the dorsal, yeah. She's definitely hooked up towards the top because she would never turn sideways. We can never get her face coming at us. Every time she would dart away when we had a dart shot. And right now she's at 977 feet out.
We don't want to break that off because we'll never find her.
Yeah.
In the dark.
Find her. My boys.
Oh, here he is, boys. I see a light.
I'm going to try to bring it around. Yeah, right on the head.
Where's the head? Nice and easy now.
Holy! Holy shnikey.
Oh my God. Look at this. Look at this.
We were given a gift. We were given a gift of weather, that we had the opportunity to run 30 miles out in the 28 hybrid. We had the tackle, everything. It was one of those days where everything lined up perfectly. Obviously, we didn't want to fight a fish for 12 hours, but you know what? We did what we did. We hooked him. We never wanted to hook him in the fin, but we hooked him in the fin. We made the best of it. We didn't pull that hook. We stuck with it. It was a battle like no other. It was memories that are going to last forever. I'll be telling this story to my grandkids, and I'm sure they're going to tell their kids as well. You know, we were 40 miles away, over 40 miles away when we were done in the pitch black, and the weather still held, and everything was just right. We had the perfect opportunity, we were granted a gift, and we made the best of it.
The Keys and you got two hookers on your boat, you only need one thing.
Swordfish.
Woo! Hooker electrics, go. That is.
Just take a little longer and get her up.
Still going. Some good action.
Oh yeah, that thing, you know, in a current, it's gonna just
in a current, it's gonna be flopping away. Around, looking like it's swimming somewhere.
Woo, son.
Yeah.
I'm studying the tip, pondering life.
I figured as soon as I pulled out the sandwich, I'd get a good bite. Might have to bust out one of those beers.